All right, so welcome guys. So today we're going to be talking about how to fix the PUBG lag in this game preview version of it so you can still enjoy it a little more while waiting for updates and optimizations, things like that. First thing, manage your game. Move it to an external hard drive if you have one. Anything is better than what you have inside your Xbox. The more expensive it is, obviously, faster it will be, things like that. A fast drive will help. It's not going to be a massive difference, but it will help quite a bit, especially if you have a really fast drive. So that's the first thing out of the way. Now we're going to move on to settings, because there's quite a few things in here that you can do that will speed it up. So anything that will remove CPU processing from what your Xbox is constantly doing is going to help you here. So everything in this list here shouldn't actually affect it too much. Maybe high contrast, but I can't really see that affecting it at all. It's really just the way the color will look. Blu-ray you can skip. TV One Guide, just make sure it's on 60 hertz. You don't want 120 hertz. You're not even gonna get close to that frame rate. Just have it off just in case that affects it at all. Turn your notifications off. That will help a teeny tiny bit. Big thing here is broadcast and capture. So you want to turn all your DVR stuff totally off. Don't stream from your Xbox. Don't record in 720. Don't record in 1080. Don't have any of it on. Just disable it. That's going to be a huge boost to performance. Absolutely massive boost to performance. That aside, your Xbox app connectivity, that could help. I would say just don't connect anything while you're playing PUBG. And that will spare you the usage that it will have if you don't want to disable it and you're someone that uses your phone as like a remote for TV or whatever. So that's not really a big one. Can just leave that the way it is. Yeah, I would just leave it the way it is. Preferred video provider, you don't need feedback. You can ignore that stuff. Totally ignore it. Power and startup, totally ignore it. Connect, turn your connect off. If you have one, unplug it. I mean, it does use some of it for your facial sign-in and other stuff like that. If for whatever reason you're still using one, unplug it. You totally don't need it. Wouldn't even worry about it. And then your video fidelity, 24 bits standard color space. I had mine maxed out, 1080p. Turn that stuff off. Don't allow anything extra. If you have a 4K Xbox One X, disable that. Play in 1080p. If you really want to get every ounce of performance, then I would say over here where it says 1080p, drop it down to 720p if you really, really care about those frames. And that's going to be the best of the best. It's not going to be any better than that. That's going to be using every ounce of power that this thing has got and as little processing as possible to get you the frames that you want. Other than that, you really don't need anything else. If you really want to take it that extra mile, I don't know how much turning off automatic updates will do. That's the only other thing I can think of where maybe it searches every once in a while for an update or something like that. But I wouldn't really worry about that. I believe it does that on like power down and things like that, or standbys activation. So you can totally ignore that anyway. Hopefully you guys enjoyed. That's all the advice I have for now. So if you liked it, leave a like. If you didn't like it, dislike it. Leave a comment, tell me why. Subscribe if you want to see some more stuff. I will be streaming later. And also, my apologies for any background noise during the video, but that's it. See you guys in the next one.